In 3, 2, 1. Ew. Ew.
What the fuck is that?
Oh no.
You said you. What's like? What's one of them dolls that you pull the string and it just goes, "Mama"?
Fucking scary. Horrifying.
Yeah. It's like that's well, that's what you sounded like.
Yeah, sweet.
To me, anyway.
Is it really bad that I imagined? You know, in Toy Story, the kid Sid.
Yeah.
The kid.
You know, like he had the little doll, and then it got repaired, and there was just a pterodactyl's head on it.
Dude, that doll was fucking rad.
That was awesome. Like that's every time I picture someone saying like the doll with the mama thing, like that's the doll I picture.
Mm.
Don't know why.
No, silence. I get it.
Anyway. Silence is good content. I like it. Yeah. All right. Hey, welcome back, everyone. It seems like we haven't done this for fucking ages.
Because we haven't done it for fucking ages. It's been like almost 3 weeks.
Yeah, it's because we had to bulk record because I was going away for a bit.
Yeah.
And sure. I'm back.
Inconsiderate of you.
You're causing problems.
I wasn't causing problems. We recorded them bulk. I edited them, and they went up all right.
And then you fucked off to download.
Where's the problem, though?
Places.
Yeah.
Places are the problem.
Yeah.
Makes sense. What words was I going to say?
Fucking hell, we met into that.
Well, you know, it's always a surprise. So this is podcast number 26.
Yeah.
Hope everybody enjoyed the slightly different kind of podcast that we did last time. I really enjoyed doing that. I feel like we should do more stuff like that.
Yeah, that was fun.
I enjoyed watching it.
It was really different. I don't know. I like how the flow of it went because there was game right there that we were actually involved in. It was a good flow. I liked that. So yeah, what's everybody been doing since last time we recorded?
Not a lot.
I got engaged.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you did.
I was really hoping he would go. I can't think of
much
I've done. So, Ross, I've deliberately not asked until this point.
Yes.
You got engaged.
Yes.
How'd you do it? What was the story?
Like
good content. Good. Thanks.
Well, from what I heard before we started recording, Jess is there, so we should get her on to tell us.
Nah.
Yeah.
She'll butcher. Nah. We went glamping, which is glamorous camping.
Ooh, familiar.
I'd planned to do like, so it was middle of fucking nowhere. So like, we were gonna go for a walk at night and look at the stars and shit. It was gonna be romantic as fuck.
Aww.
The weather decided to fuck me on that one. So I had to very quickly come up with an alternative, which I had not planned for. So you know the post-it note game.
What?
Yeah,
the post-it note game. You write a celebrity on a post-it note, stick it to the other person's forehead, and they've got to guess who they are.
Yes.
Aye.
We played that in Glasgow when we went to Comic-Con.
Yeah. We played a few rounds of that, and then after about maybe 5 or 6, I wrote on hers, Jess, will you marry me, and stuck it to her forehead and made her guess who she was. To the point where she couldn't get it, and started getting really annoyed at me. She's like, well, who the fuck am I then? I was like, well, fucking look at your piece of paper. So she tears it off her forehead, looks at it, goes like, huh? And then turns to me, and like the rings, I've got the ring out, like, fit under the pillow, I'm like, ta-da, and that was that.
That's what you call
pretty smooth. Good. Cool way to go about it.
Yeah, that was smooth as fuck. I've got to say.
That's fucking silky, man.
Yeah, that's like, you were one of those guys that like fucking yawned and then suddenly had their arm round like a girlfriend as well, weren't you?
No, I never did that.
Nah, you should have.
Fuck, I did that.
You could have fucking pulled that off.
I was
attempted it once. It didn't work.
Hey, what?
I missed that. What?
So that was the dick in the pot, punk.
Oh, yeah, that I could believe.
yeah, I'm engaged now, so that's a thing.
So when do you think you'll actually get married then?
I don't know. Sometime.
Some point.
At some point.
Committal, I like it.
Very much, yeah. Very much so. is insert name we can't say on podcast going to be your best man? The hilarity of it would be good.
Just imagine the speech.
All three words of it.
Yeah.
I don't know who you're What are you talking about?
What? Stop playing Arkham fucking Dead Engine.
I'm not. Okay, I am. Right.
Ever since podcast 20, Ross, you've just been totally non-committed.
There's nothing to do. Like,
it's there just is! Talking. There's talking!
It's just like we're playing Xbox, right? We're talking.
We actually have a Xbox. We have
playing the Xbox part of that.
We have a fucking better conversation when we're all in a party in the Xbox.
Yeah, but half I think it's because when we're on a party in the Xbox, like Chris is saying, we cannot put out like half of what we talk about.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, we absolutely can.
I mean, shit, I made a remark in the last one that I had to get cut. Not even my request.
Yeah. Which one? Oh, yeah, I know what that was.
Yeah.
I was confused at what it was for a second, and then I remembered. Holy shit.
In light of recent events, I really can't fucking say it.
Oh, shit, yeah. Yeah, that's been happening as well. Like, shootings in Orlando. This happened. Was it Orlando?
Yeah, Orlando.
This all happened when I was away. I'm still kind of catching up with that shit.
Did you see MP was shot today?
Yeah, she got shot and stabbed. She didn't make it through.
Who was it? Like Joe in America.
Joe Cox.
No, it was Scottish MP. I
think. Oh, really? Fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah, the voice on it was Joe Cox or something.
Yeah, I think it was Joe.
Yeah, it was Joe Cox.
We had a death up here on Monday, the day I was coming back. Anyway, we had a death up here, which has rocked the local area. It seems like quite a lot of shit goes down this year.
It's 2016, man. It's just out to get everyone.
Yeah, there's been a fuck ton of death this year.
Like. Fucking
a lot of good celebrities.
The lead guitar player from the Wings band died today as well.
Really? Fuck.
Yeah.
Who?
I can't even remember his name, but he was the guy played with Paul McCartney when he recorded Live and Let Die.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, he died today as well. I can't remember his name though.
I can't think of it off the top of my head either. I want to say it's. I don't want to say, because I'm going to be way off.
Like, someone will know it. That's fine. Don't worry.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, fuck it. I don't care. Yeah. I don't care what we do with that. But, Chris, what are you not saying?
I got accepted to college again.
Oh, yeah, so you did. Yeah, that was in our break as well. Fucking, yeah, well done.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, I'm going back to redo my HNC.
Are you...
Finish my HNC, rather.
Yeah, are you going to work up to your degree, or
I'm hopefully going to work up to the master's. Fingers
Ooh,
crossed.
Wow.
Yeah, really, it's another 5 years. I'll be at least 30 by the time I finish education.
Jesus.
And then I've still got like the year of or 2 years of teacher training as well. So, yeah.
Are you going to go and be a teacher then? Are you?
I mean, that's kind of what I'm set on just now. So,
fair.
Fingers crossed. But I might like become like an independent guitar tutor or something.
Yeah, that works too. You can actually be a really fucking good independent guitar tutor just with a HND, because I did that for a long time.
Yeah, you can.
The HND seemed to attract like quite a few people that kind of took you as you had like the diploma, so you must know your shit at least to teach the basics. Mm.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, like one of my old guitar tutors, I think he's still there, had to get his degree before he could teach HNC.
Yeah, yeah.
That makes sense.
But if you're private, then you don't necessarily have to teach two gradings, you can just teach.
Mm.
It depends what you advertise your business as.
I mean, to be fair, I could go and teach now.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. Exactly.
I wouldn't, because I've forgotten half the stuff that I've learned, but...
Yeah, yeah, it's good to be kind of fresh out of education and then just kind of keep regurgitating it.
Yeah,
for everything.
That's sometimes a problem. It was like the musician. I understand music. I see the whole fucking like theoretical side of it.
Yeah,
it's been that long since I've fucking like looked at it properly. A lot of it's fucking over my head these days. Like, I still read music and that fine, but a lot of them just kind of like, what does this weird fucking Italian word mean again?
Oh, I could never understand like all the words, but reading the notes and stuff was fine.
I'll tell you one, and purely because a guy told me, here's a way to remember this one, because it was coming up in a test when I was doing HNC, Chris.
Yeah.
And he said, here's a way to remember this one, and I guarantee you will never forget this. And he was absolutely right, because I've never forgotten this, but portamento means to slide to the next note. And the reason I remember it is because he said, here's how you remember it. Port, you're on a port, it's slippy, you're sliding to the next note. That's literally true. All he said. I've never forgotten it since. He came up with some really fucking weird ways to remember something.
I'll ask a really vague question about this. Was he a man from the Glasgow area and wore a baseball cap and played bass guitar?
No.
Damn it, it's not the same person then.
I think I know who you're thinking of.
Jason.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Yeah, he was awesome. I love him.
Yeah. Is he still there?
He is still there. I believe he's still there.
Jesus. Wow.
Yeah.
He's been there a long time then.
It's been a long time. I mean, that's, what, 3 years at least I've been away?
Yeah, it's been five years since I've been at college, so yeah. Nah, that can't be right.
No, you were 4 years, because you finished your HNC when I was going into the NC. Or was you, right? you'd be on your HND.
I don't know, I finished my HND, I've got it.
Right, something about that. Something along those lines.
I can't remember. I feel like it was 4 years ago is when I left. Oh, man. You know, strangely enough, I've been really, really strongly considering going to college or university full time, and it's something I never thought I'd consider doing. But I've really been really strongly considering it recently.
That's an opinion that has changed in the last couple of weeks. Going off a conversation we had that I don't have a lane.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah, no, that's why it's something I could never see myself saying or doing. But I don't know. Like, there's just something about it. I fancy a change, and I feel like the best way to get that change is to go and get my degree in something totally different.
Yeah, but then when you've got that degree, you're just kind of like, nothing's that different. You're the same. You with a different bit of paper.
That's the risk. That is the risk. I mean, there's nothing to stop me getting into, what I really wanted to go and do was, media. Mm. In all aspects, because...
Yeah, so that's a pretty broad topic, so you can fucking narrow that one down.
Really, really fucking broad, but it's, what we do here relates to it. Stuff that I'm doing at work now relates to it. I'm doing way more press release stuff, which is media-related as well.
Fucking nightmare, that, isn't
it? Yeah, it really is. I'm writing a lot of press releases at the moment. And
absolute...
It's a bit of a pain in the ass, and yeah, ever since the new person at my work started, I was about to say a name and then realised I couldn't. ever since the new person at my work started, who's got a photography degree, I've been getting more and more into using our cameras. And like I said, we just bought a couple of Canon cameras for my work. I was saying that the other night.
I love experimenting with photography. I've also realised, the photos that I want to take, I'm going to have to buy a lot of kit.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, man.
Annoyingly. I'm gonna have to get, a remote shutter, neutral density filters, all that shit. And it's just fuck.
Yeah, I'm really strongly considering maybe not buying myself a camera, but, maybe asking for it for, birthday and Christmas this year or something.
The one that Shawnee's got, she got that one and a second lens for $299, I want to say.
Yeah, if you shop around, you're getting for no bad. I mean, Canon cameras, the
1200D's the one that.
Yeah.
Right, the 1200D's the one that Shawnee's got. That's the one that I've been using most recently. And it's a great camera.
Yeah, I've got a 40D kicking about as well. It's a fucking great camera.
The 1300D's just been released recently, and it's like the 1200D, just a little bit better processor, a couple of bit of tweaks, and it's just general little improvements.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, we've got...
The good thing about the Canon cameras as well is, you got a fucking app for your phone that, runs through lessons, tutorials, that sort of shit for it as well.
Yeah, it's really good.
You can get them, dedicated to the camera you have as well. So it's not just, a vague, this is for Canon cameras. This is for your Canon camera.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
I'm still a huge fan of film photography. Still really into that.
You get a surprisingly high quality image out of it.
Yeah.
Not really surprising. I mean, you got a decent camera, it's not surprising. Yeah. It's just you've not got that instant, okay, this worked and this didn't.
Yeah.
You've kind of got to take it and hope for the best.
Yeah, you've got to bracket your shots. Fucking take maybe two or three photos of the same thing with different settings, just to, in the hope that one of them pans out.
Yeah. Fucking. Well, what else have I been doing? That's...
You went to download.
You went to Comic Con.
Yeah, I've been to Comic Con and download. That's, oh, fucking hell.
And Aberdeen.
Have I mentioned I'm tired? No, I'm good, honestly. I don't know. I came back, I was really, really revitalised. I've been back at work for like 3 days and I'm fucked off with it already. That's how long the holiday high lasted.
That's like, since you walk through that fucking door, it's gone.
Straight down again.
Fucking Ross is giving me a ray of sunshine on Monday.
Yeah.
Oh, are you off just now, Ross?
Yeah, I'm off till Monday.
He's been off for a week.
Fucking weather's been shit. I finally went out on my bike today and I'm fucking soaked.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the thing. I got a new motorbike.
Yeah, you did as well.
Yeah, you did.
I got a new car. Yeah. Fucking loads of shit's been happening. Fucking hell.
I got new socks.
I got my beard trimmed today.
Ooh.
It was great. Yeah, it was great.
Alex, firing on them. Alex.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, you spoiled that. I was going to ask really dramatically what's on them.
Yeah. Oh, well, one's got fireman on them. I still can't say if it's a fucking builder or a lollipop man. I really can't decide.
What's on the other ones?
Put it in the chat.
Oh. That's fucking dense. It doesn't wash, motherfucker. I got any of them still up here. I do. The chef ones are still here.
Yeah. Chef ones are awesome.
Chef ones. Yeah. Has anybody been keeping up with shit that's going on at E3 and what are you excited about?
I'm excited for Scorpio. I'm not gonna lie.
Fucking stoked about Titanfall 2.
Yeah, Titanfall 2 is gonna be good.
I'm excited for Halo Wars 2.
Me too.
Halo Wars 2 is really good.
Yeah.
I'm actually the only one in the group that's not fucking like hyped on that.
I mean, I've only played a couple of matches on the beta, but I enjoyed what I played.
Yeah, I'm the same. I feel like your experience from Halo Wars 1 can still benefit you as well, because I played a couple of matches. The first match I got in, my ally left straight away, and I only lost by 110 tickets or something.
It's not bad.
Like, I was still able to like sort of learn the new mechanics and figure out the best way to do it quick enough to still put up a good fight against two people, which was good. I liked that. I'm trying to think. Fucking, when is it coming out? February?
It's quite a while off. February next year, January, February next year.
Yeah.
Something like that.
It's really bizarre that like a beta is out for that and it's so fucking polished at this point. Because that game looks good.
I was really surprised.
It does look really good.
The only thing I'll say is like the loading times need a little bit of an improvement because they can take a while, but that I expected that.
I to be fair, I didn't actually think.
If it's a beta build, then like you can't ask for too much.
Yeah.
I also didn't think really the loading times were that bad compared to the first one. They're fucking like twice as short.
Oh yeah.
First one loaded slow as shit.
Yeah, like I mean that's why I didn't complain, because I know that it's the first beta build. They're gonna need to have that extra load time.
Yeah, just to make sure.
Which is fair. Works. Yeah.
Fucking, although I did have Halo Wars, I got the first one for 80 pence. Match.
You got fucking Halo Wars for 80 pence, Jesus.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. 80 pence well spent.
Yeah.
We all just
not really. I didn't enjoy it, but
we all just picked up Battlefield 4 recently. I haven't actually played it yet.
Like, we should play it after this.
I'm so bad at it now.
You can play it after.
You'll learn to be good at it.
Yeah. Oh, do you know that takes me on to a good story? Fucking love how that technology works. I seen that it was cheap the night before that I said anything about it. Because I decided to wait until the morning because I was going to bed anyway. I just happened to look at that before I went to bed. And then I messaged you guys in the morning because I know that Alex and Ross, you guys both had it anyway.
Yeah, we've been playing it a lot recently.
And I just had to ask if it was Battlefield 4 that you had because it was on cheap again and I was considering going to pick it up so that we could have another game that we could all play together.
And then me and Ross were both a little salty about that, to be honest.
Yeah, because it went on... Half the price that you guys bought it for. But to be fair, like, I fucking loved that because we spoke about it as I was leaving for work in the morning. Decided that I would actually buy it at work from the app on my phone. I came back home and when I turned on my Xbox, fair enough, we ended up playing GTA that night, but when I turned on my Xbox I got the notification that it was ready to play. And I love the fact that I fucking bought that on my phone, not even in the fucking house, and because my Xbox is set up as my home one, and it's on instant on, just fucking installed when I was away. It was great.
Yeah.
I fucking love that.
I said in the chat as well about, like, fucking Taken King. I was in Barcelona when I bought that.
Yeah.
Like, I bought that on the Friday, came back on the Tuesday, and just first thing I done was fucking sit and play that.
It works so well. Such a fucking good idea and a good system.
I've yet to actually use it.
It's really good. The only thing I'll say is, like, Xbox needs to really update their iOS app because it's broken as fuck right now.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, the like, Android
nobody
one,
can sign into it.
The Android one works really well at the moment.
I'm pretty sure they just had a fucking update as well.
Still doesn't work. It's still broken as fuck.
I think that's what broke it. Because I've been able to sign it with no issues until...
Well, they've had...
I noticed that the tile changed on my phone as well.
Yeah, it's not the Smart Glass app anymore. It's just Xbox app. But they've had two updates since the E3 launched, and both of them have been broken as shit.
What else is on at E3? Has anybody seen the new Legend of Zelda? Because that looks fucking awesome.
Fucking... I'm sick of Nintendo.
I feel what you're getting at there, Alex.
Every fucking year, it's like Zelda, fucking Gizmo games.
Do you know
Alex with the salt.
Zelda and Smash Bros.
No, look, I've been playing Nintendo games.
They just
before I could fucking walk.
They just fucking recycled them round.
Yeah. I am sick of playing Zelda games. I'm sick of playing fucking Mario games. I want something new. And I don't want fucking Pikmin again.
So you complain when there's nothing first... new. There's something new.
My real issue is, like, when that was first new and came out, great. It took them, 16 years to put out a fucking game that wasn't Zelda or Mario?
Yep. Oh, they're Donkey Kong.
I suppose.
Donkey!
Like, that game...
We got, two of them or something like that? Like, we didn't get any of them.
Yeah, although you did get Donkey Konga on the GameCube.
Oh, yeah, we did.
With the bong.
Monkey Ball?
That was a great game. Monkey Ball was awesome.
Do you know what the weirdest thing is, right? And I think, I don't know if it's discussed this on a video, but fuck it, it's happening just now as well. But the thing that I always find really weird is the one console that I play very rarely is Nintendo consoles. I very rarely play them.
Mm.
But when asked who, like, my favourite sort of video game characters are, they're all, like, Nintendo and Sega characters. Every single one of them. They to me, are the memorable characters, the games that I really enjoyed, and probably the franchises that I'm most invested in. Like, Zelda, Sonic, fucking Super Metroid, like, Pokemon. Those are the franchises that, like, scream to me, like, the shit that I'm really fucking into and love.
However, were they the games that you grew up playing?
That's exactly what I was going to ask him.
Or are they purely for the character's character?
Both, I would say. Both. Sonic is definitely because I grew up playing it sort of thing, because it was Sonic 2 was like the first Sega game that I ever played.
Yeah, I played that one.
It was the first, like, I think 16-bit game that I ever played.
Yeah.
So it was really a lot of firsts for me was that game, and it was fucking awesome.
That's what I'm like with Super Mario World.
Mm.
The first game I ever played. No, fuck the hell, it was Pong.
We
can't really count in Pong because that's not any characters.
Yeah. I was not massively into Mario at any point.
I was a massive Mario fan, like, back in the day.
I did grow up playing a lot of fucking Pokemon, and I got out of it for a really long time. I'm sort of verging on back into it at this point. Like, I tend to buy the latest game and play it for a bit. Sometimes I take...
I'm trying to get back into it, but until I buy a new fucking 3DS, it's not going to happen.
I want to buy a DS, but I'm so confused at them all. It's just like, I'm not even going to bother.
There's new
3DS, and there's like the new 3DS, and there's like the XL, and there's like the... new 2DS and the new one.
What I will say is fucking get an XL, because I've got small hands and the 3DS kills my hands.
I'm not gonna get a 3DS. I don't really like 3D.
Just turn it off. You wanted to be able to fold. You wanted to fit in your pocket. The only problem with buying a 2DS is it doesn't fucking fit in your pocket.
He's got a point.
Yeah.
Because
I
don't really see the point in the 2DS either. Like, no. I thought like the point of the 3D, like the DS, was to be portable. Like, it's meant to be like Game Boy.
Yeah, I don't understand why they've built the 2DS as basically the same size as an open DS all the fucking time. Like, that's
money.
But if you're gonna, if you think that enough people are not gonna want the 3D, just ship the exact same fucking thing, but take the 3D processor out.
Yeah, I would be more than happy with a 3DS XL size console without the 3D.
Yep. Because as soon as I bought my 3DS, I turned on the 3D, went, that hurts my head, turned it off, and I've never fucking turned it back.
Never turned it on again.
It doesn't hurt my head, I just can't see it very well.
I'm sort of...
I couldn't see it very well either.
I'm sort of the same. It's something about the way... Because it's a filtered screen, and the way that it projects the 3D really fucking fucks with my brain.
To me, Rachel, it's
let's figure something out here. The three of us wear glasses, Ross. You wear glasses?
Yes.
How often?
Only when I'm driving. And even at that, not often.
If you're playing your 3DS, assuming without glasses, can you see the 3D?
Yes.
Right, so I'd put it down to being the fucking glasses.
It's quite possibly a thing. It could be
the lens is fucking it.
It's the same reason that Snapchat, like the fucking face filters, work really shitly with your detecting your face if you've got your glasses on.
Yeah. So I had a cracking fucking face swap with it.
Yeah,
wow, that one was great.
Yeah, it was a treat, that one.
Like my future brother-in-law.
Seems like a nice guy.
Yes. Name's Alex as well. Really confusing.
He's got a bad taste in motorcycles, though.
Yeah, he has terrible taste in motorcycles. Fucking, before he had that, he had a fucking 50cc Peugeot scooter.
Oh, why would you do that?
Wow.
Please tell me it was one of the ones that are made to look like they're Sportsters. Please.
Yeah.
Yeah!
It was a piece of shit.
You need to tell me some real power between those legs.
Oh, boy.
I had mine today. I was out on it, and I just went out for a wee run, because it was finally dry enough to do it.
Mm.
And I missed it. Oh, like, I got onto a bit of Joe Carriageway, and it was 40 for a long time, and then it switched to, like, national speed limit after, like, a roundabout.
Mm.
The burst of power I had coming out of that roundabout was so nice. I went from 20 to 70 in, like, a couple seconds. It was fantastic.
Yeah, that new bike is going to be fast. Is it a 500 you've got?
It's 500, yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be quite fast.
It's fucking fantastic. I love it.
I need to go through my bike test.
Yeah, so
I'm probably not going to. For the amount I've thought about it, I don't think I'll ever actually own a bike.
Yeah, but, like, you don't really need to, though, because you've got a fairly quick car.
Yeah, it's pretty quick, to be fair.
I just need something that's going to get me from A to B and not kill me, preferably.
I was going to do this year and get back in ice hockey instead, so...
Yeah, I was, funnily enough, at the end of last year, start of this year, I was really thinking about getting my bike, even just a sort of, what's the word I'm looking for?
CBT?
That's the one, yeah, even just a CBT license and get just a 125 to kick about on and see how I got on with it this year to see whether or not I'd want to do it.
Mm.
See, that's what I'm thinking, like, if I just get a CBT in it, like a reasonable 125, and use it for going to college when I don't have to take an instrument with me.
Yeah,
like I just have to take a bag or something. Like that would be perfect.
Yeah, yeah, it'll save you a lot of money, bus wise.
Yeah,
yeah. Just I mean, don't buy a fucking Lexmoor.
Like, oh no, yeah. Like even then, like I'll just like take a bus or get a carpool or something when I need to take my guitar or whatever.
Yeah,
which isn't a big deal. Yeah, well, when she's not working. Which is all the fucking time.
Fucking mind when we all first started college and we all used to carpool in my old car.
Yeah, dude.
And we fitted, I want to say, my bass.
Two guitars.
A bass, two guitars.
Five people.
Five people and two amps. All in that one fucking wee Golf.
Fuck it.
It was great. Terrace. It was fucking great.
It was Tetris. It was great.
Yeah. Tetris with people.
Fucking, you know, it's great fun trying to move a couple of cabs using a fucking small hatchback.
God, that's awful.
We had to move, it was two cabs, a couple of heads, as well as, like, guitars, and this small hatchback. It took about 40 seconds to get up to 60, just because of the weight.
We had, I did a gig up in Aberdeen, and it was in a little sit-run, I think it was a sit-run, it was like a sit-run Saxo or whatever it was.
Yeah, Saxo was a pretty common, first car.
Yeah.
My mum had one of
them. Like, two big, 120 watt heads in the boot. Five people in that car going from Dundee to Aberdeen, and three of the band members, myself included, had to take the mega bus up to Aberdeen because there was no room.
I came in there when we were in college. One of the guys was there. We had a Nissan Micra, and there was one back seat the car itself was alright, but there was this one back seat that we all referred to as the pedo seat.
This is a story.
Yeah. Because it's one of those ones where the fucking seatbelts have got that auto lock thing, so if you hit something, you don't face plant at the guy in front of you.
Yeah.
Right, well, it was broken in that one.
Okay.
So once you clicked it in and then let the seatbelt go, couldn't move. I made the mistake of trying to lean back in the seat to get something. Turn back around. I was basically constricted into the seat. I could barely breathe.
It was less than ideal.
That was some more. But he did manage to get a full fucking drum kit in the back of it, which was pretty fucking impressive.
That's impressive.
Yeah. It was he brought a full drum kit and a drummer.
Always handy.
Yeah. Well, you got to remember your drummer.
Yeah.
To be fair, the guy was although, fucking tiny. So,
yeah. Although that being said, there was one gig we had to play because our drummer was away at I want to say he was at a Christian camp thing.
Nice.
Because he was he was quite religious.
He's a lord.
Yeah. So what we had to do was we had to go to the studio that would. Recorded a pre-production of our EP, get the isolated drum tracks with a click on them so that we could play them through the PA as a backing track so we could play the gig. So we then referred to him as Robo Insert Name.
Robo Insert Name. I like it. I like how you do
it. It was Robo Dog. If he watches this, you'll know exactly what it is.
I feel like can we just mention names? Are we gonna? I feel like the vagueness is kind of funny at times.
The vagueness is funny. Yeah. With one particular member of the group.
I think we should just be vague with that one member. It just makes it better.
It's that's one person.
I was gonna ask actually.
I get a snap for Ross.
Probably yeah. So did I. I probably shouldn't do this on podcast. No wait, we'll check this. I'm going to have to check this. Hold on. That's a good one.
That was good.
I like that. I feel that particular member of our group, I feel at the moment is feeling really left out.
I mean, he needs to move from the Stone Age.
Should...
You missed this one, Jamie. You absolutely missed this one.
No, you can't bring it up because it's
no, we won't.
No, we can't. We can't bring this up. We'll tell you after.
I was about to say, let's talk about this after. That sounds like a good story.
It's relevant to your fucking story as well, though.
If I could tell, I absolutely would, but I can't.
Yeah.
Okay. Fair enough. This has interested me. We'll get around to that later. Off camera. Off camera.
We have convinced me to come to a nightclub, though. That's always
that's interesting. Wow.
We managed to convince me to come to the Catty Biz.
Although, when he sees this, because he knows exactly who he is, he's probably going to shout at us.
However, I've got a way to save this. Should
Beep.
He let, should no. No, 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 no. This is all staying in. This is gold.
Yeah. Yeah.
Should we? Because I've noticed from our antics last night that he doesn't have a crew anymore. Because he was feeling lonely. Should we let him into BAPS?
Well, that depends. He needs to at least do something beneficial for us.
He was on the podcast.
Was he? Oh yes, he was. Yeah,
if he was fucking finish off,
you know what, right?
Shit we asked him to do, then sure.
Yeah. At this point we should just say the fucker's name. He knows.
Yeah, he knows.
Billy.
Billy.
Billy Heath.
Just that's an actual name. Our
I know it's an actual name, but it's not him, so it's fine.
Good old Billy.
Billy Heath.
I miss Billy.
People listening to this that don't know who any of our fucking people.
Speaking of Billy,
I don't know who half these cunts are.
I emptied Billy of berries this morning. It was interesting.
Yeah, you did.
What's a what?
Fucking 2 tons of berries from Billy. Billy's a brontosaurus in Ark.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, Chris has been playing Ark.
Ah, right, he bought that as well. Sweet.
Fucking Ross tied on the tunic and just handed him the fucking needle.
Yeah. I was looking at it. Yes, you said, yes. Do it. I'm like, fuck it.
And then,
sometimes you don't take a lot of convincing, Chris. I've noticed that.
Well, the thing is, like, I was meant to be house-sitting and dog-sitting for 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought, I want a new game that's going to keep me occupied for at least a week, like at least minimum a week.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, I like the survival style games. I like dinosaurs.
Ark.
This kind of makes sense. Yeah. And I know that some of you guys play it as well. So at least I'm not playing it on my own.
Yeah.
And yeah. But it turns out that it rained at the campsite that they were at all week. So they came home today.
They got their house clean. They came home early, basically.
Yeah. I cleaned the house top to bottom.
Very good of you, indeed.
And all I got was 20 fucking quid. Which I thought was great, because I wasn't expecting anything.
Yeah, that's all right, then.
Yeah, can't agree with that.
I do like when you originally do something for nothing and end up getting something for it. That's probably the best thing. The thing that fucks me off is expecting to get something for it and then not getting anything for it. That annoys me.
Yeah. I mean, at this point, I don't really expect anything from anyone. Like, because
I've been more like that.
Speaking
recently.
Of which, I sold Jimmy 20 quid.
So you do, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, speaking of which, Ross owes me money still.
What do I owe you money for?
Speaking of that, I owe you money still, Ross.
We're so bad at this.
Yeah.
Right, Chris, why do you owe me money?
Because you bought me a BAPS t-shirt and I haven't given you the money for it.
Yeah.
That was from the first run.
Or was that Jamie?
No, it was Jamie that bought two. I only bought one.
Chris, take that money, give it to Jamie. That's me paid Jamie.
Okay.
That's a good way of doing it.
Because I owe Jamie money, so this clears my debt.
It clears your debt without you having to fucking give me any money, is what it does.
Look, I forgot you owed me money. You owed me money.
I did.
That's how the economy works.
I feel like it's exactly the same amount as well.
That cunt owes me money. I owe this cunt money. Take that cunt's money, give it to that cunt.
Yeah. She's cut out of mine.
As it's my favourite photo that floated around the internet for a while. I don't know if it's still floating about, but for ages there was a photo that was floating around that was the world is something like $4.9 trillion in debt.
Does the world owe fucking money to?
Yeah, that's ended up like that was what was floating around, and then it became a meme because it's like it was that, and then below it was like just one of the meme photos of somebody going, "What the fuck do we owe Pluto?"
Fucking a lot at this point.
Yeah,
I'll sleep with that little guy.
Apology at the very best.
Well, yeah, that's one way to do it.
Okay, I would say, like, maybe Jupiter. Like, to me, seems like the fucking mob boss of the universe. Fucking Jupiter.
Like, if we owe money to if the Earth was money, why does it have to be dollars? Like,
because I think US dollar is... It's not even the most common currency.
Could it not just be, like, space credits?
It's the most common, but it's not the strongest.
Yeah,
like, we owe space credits.
That always confuses me.
At least that's unanimous.
Is US dollar the most common currency?
Absolutely.
Most widespread, yeah.
See, yeah, because I always
just fucking everywhere.
I always just think it's the thing that everybody converts shit to.
At the very least, the dollar is the most common currency term.
Yeah.
So
it kind of makes sense.
Like, New Zealand use it, Canada use it, fucking Australia.
It makes sense that the biggest country that uses it is the one that's the main term.
Yeah, that's true. Even just for volume of people using that currency in their own country.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's going to be most dominant just because it is the most populated continent.
Yeah, that and probably someone from America made the picture.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, yeah, as well.
And folk in America may have no concept of the outside world like at all.
Is it true that on American maps, America's in the middle? Yes. I heard that once.
A lot of them, yeah. It's also true that people think that the world is just America.
What?
Like, some Americans
believe that it's only America on the whole planet. It's just America.
Is that what they refer to as, like, land is America?
No, that's what they refer to as the world.
See the way Britain used to look at the world?
Is that how some Americans look at it?
Okay. It's basically like America and here be worms.
All right.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. American shit we haven't blown up yet.
Yeah.
Whoa, that's a bit tough.
Oil. Like, there's the oil.
Yeah, pretty much.
Here be worms.
Whereas we're like, here's Britain and everything we used to own.
Mm-hmm. I've got a story.
Go on.
Sorry. I'm excited.
I went to Comic-Con.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, you fuck.
I met the head of RC UK. I was in an AWU, which I think is going to be the next one, actually. I think it was 322 we did. So that will be a thing. I met what seemed like thousands of people.
Probably pretty accurate. I mean,
all the RT UK folks that came along.
Like, at the very least, like it was in London, so there was gonna be a lot of people.
I think at the meet there was over 300 people. I don't know if that's an exaggeration, but that was every single day that they had a meet outside Comic-Con. There was 300. There was at least 300 Rooster Teeth fans that came out.
That's a traffic jam, that is.
Yeah, yeah. We were right outside the XL, out the back doors where nobody else was really, and we just kind of cornered a section to ourselves.
That one bit of grass. The one bit of grass in all of London.
I've actually found more bits of grass in London than I expected.
Yeah.
Fucking newsflash, there's fucking grass everywhere.
Yeah. I actually didn't. Like, I don't think I saw... I maybe saw, like, one patch of grass. That was Hyde Park. But it was all covered in boards because I went to Winter Wonderland.
Mm.
So it was all covered, but it was great.
Yeah. I've
got another question for you as well on that subject that I have to ask you later on because it will have to be beeped out.
Do it now and we can just beep it.
Okay.
No, don't give me work.
Right, Jamie, right?
What?
When you were walking about, right, how many buses did you see?
Fucking loads.
How many white bus drivers did you see?
Quite a few.
I'm glad you asked.
Quite a few. Do you know, I think we can leave that in, actually.
That's the thing. It's a genuine thing. I did not see one white bus driver in that whole like week that I was there.
I seen a few.
How many waitresses did you see as well?
Fucking loads.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen the picture of the?
It's almost like Starbucks. It's like one on every corner.
Have you?
Honestly, I had never seen a waitress until I went to London.
Yeah. Have you seen the picture of the North-South divide as illustrated by Waitrose?
What, London and peasants?
No, it's fucking hilarious. Seriously, go into Google Maps and just type in Waitrose and then zoom out of the UK. There is one in Edinburgh, and then every single other fucking Waitrose is in England, and there's fucking thousands of them. Seriously, Google that.
No, that's not true anymore. Wait, no.
Fucking make up your mind.
There's two in Edinburgh.
Oh,
they've opened another one.
There's one in Stirling. There's one in Bearsden.
Why Stirling? Bearsden makes sense.
There's one...
I can't believe they've added more. I need to go to the map.
There's one at Hillhead, just outside Glasgow.
There's one in Byers Road, so west end of Glasgow. There's one in Mulgay.
There's one at Gateshead. There's one at Pontland.
There's a fucking crow tapping my window.
See a picture.
And then the rest are in London.
Yeah.
Or England.
They're
fuck off!
Oh,
that's awesome.
So it's not a crow, it's a fucking magpie.
It's fucking with you.
Tell it you've got a podcast.
I've got a fucking podcast. Go away.
That's awesome. This is the best thing.
Wow.
What if?
That was an event.
No, open the window. Okay, it's away.
Just let it in and let it speak. How much tail? Yeah, how's the story?
Oh boy.
It's gone. My neighbour's looking at me. I think they heard me.
Give them a finger.
Do it. No, I'm fucking, I'm back in the room now.
Oh, that was gold as shit. I love shit like that.
I'm so glad that was on the
list. I definitely think we can leave that in. That was not as bad as I thought it was going to be when you fucking brought it up.
My question is... fucking fucked up, bro.
He's a young one, though.
Did you get a...
Yeah, I got a photo in the chat.
Yeah! That's awesome, I'm saving that.
I'm looking away as well.
Might even throw that up. Nah, I'm not gonna, that's work.
Bonus.
You said
no. Fuck, yeah.
You can see his little foot in that one.
I do it now.
Please. yeah, while I was at Comic-Con, did get the chance to meet a Mr. Gavin Free as well.
Yeah, you did.
He was very nice.
I'm glad I finally know how tall Gavin is. Now I've got some like reference. Yeah,
you've got a former reference. He was about as tall as I imagined him, to be honest. I was surprised that he wasn't taller.
Meg seems smaller than what I thought she'd be.
Meg's fucking tiny.
Meg is very small. She's small. Met her as well.
It's like, I think the issue is like with these folk, like I've only really seen them around each other.
Yeah. And you don't have a frame of reference.
Never, like, I've not got any reference to how tall they actually are. I don't actually know their heights.
Well, now...
I know Joel's meant to be tall as shit. But yeah. Other than that, I've no idea.
Well, it's quite good now, because, like, using me as a reference against Meg and Gavin, you can start to create a chart.
Yeah, a rough idea.
How tall they're going to be. No, that was...
The thing that really bugs me, though, but, like, I'll come back to it after you went through this, actually. Go on.
I mean, I wasn't going to say much, but it was just, like, it was really... It's really bizarre, because that was, like, one of the first times, I suppose, aside from meeting Tom Scal at Glasgow Comic-Con last time,
mm-hmm.
It was one of the few times that I'd met someone that, like, I know so much about their life, like, really, their real life as well, like, not a celebrity. Mm-hmm. You meet a celebrity... Unless they're a reality TV star of some sort, you typically don't know a lot about their lives, you just know a lot about the roles that they've played.
Yeah.
You know, like, if you met, for example, Ryan Reynolds, you'd be thinking Deadpool and everybody else, you know, that he's portrayed over the years. Like, you wouldn't necessarily know anything about his personal life.
Good looking, man.
He is very good looking. And he fucking sells it so well. He's got a good...
Hey,
but it's people that like sort of Gavin and Meg, the sort of internet content creator people that typically only speak about their own lives, and that is their, you know, their sort of internet celebrity status is their own life and experience. And it was just really kind of bizarre actually seeing and hearing that a voice that you're so familiar with hearing, but it's like actually like right there. The thing, you know, the person that produces that voice is not digitally.
This person exists, like in reality.
It's real.
Not just a voice over Minecraft.
Yeah, exactly. It's just one of those really, like, that was the bizarrest thing about it. It really was. Gavin's also exactly as you would expect, by the way. Exactly.
Yeah, I always figured that about him. I didn't think that his sort of personality on, like, podcasts and that was in any way, like, a front.
No, it absolutely was. Like, he is incredibly, like, from meeting him, I can definitely vouch for him being insanely genuine with everything
he's like.
Because he just, I don't know, he's just one of those kind of people. It's just fucking, it's great. Like, at the time, like, we only found out about it, like, the morning that he was there. Fucking Craig had known since Friday, but he couldn't tell anybody anything.
Yeah, it makes sense.
For obvious reasons. And obviously we only knew the second that he was at the booth. And we'd just gotten into con for that day as well. So we just basically, like, we finished what was essentially our breakfast and then fucking went to go and meet him.
Right.
What did you have for breakfast?
want to say noodles. I think it was noodles.
Fucking what?
That's an odd breakfast.
Yeah, but it was a late breakfast.
Fucking carb loading, man. Jesus Christ.
So it was more brunch than anything else.
Yeah, it was more brunch than anything. Yeah.
Fancy.
Yeah.
Might have even just been an early lunch, depending on how you looked at it. It was very late in the day. But yeah, like we kind of just went over there. We stood in the line to meet him, and I just listened to the sort of interactions he was having. Like, he asked me something as well, and I can't remember what he asked, but like, it was such a genuine question. He just seemed really, really confused. And he asked me something, and I can't remember what it was. That's annoying me now.
I can only imagine what interaction between you and Gavin would be like.
And
because like I've always said that you're like our fucking Gavin.
In a lot of ways.
Yeah.
A lot of ways. More than I'm happy about, but yeah. but yeah, just like genuinely, like I answered his question, and his reaction was just kind of like,
why that. But then like
that's where babies come from.
Like you see you listen to him on like Achievement Hunter and the podcast and stuff, and he comes off as kind of like he's a little bit, you know,
loopy.
Yeah. But then see when you ask him about like film stuff, he's like a fucking genius.
Yeah.
Yeah, he really knows his like, film stuff.
He knows his shit.
Actually, that's like
someone
what
we
do is find out what Jimmy knows about.
Yeah.
One day we'll find out.
Yeah. What I know about.
What Jimmy knows.
Yeah.
I imagine I've got a source of untapped knowledge somewhere.
Probably. I think everyone has one passion that they know a lot more than anything else about.
My memory for like games and films and TV shows is really good. I've found that quite a lot. Like I'm pretty sure I sat down to play through Half-Life 2. Well, I want to say just earlier on this year, but it's been 4 or 5 years since I've actually played just through the stock, bog standard Half-Life 2.
Mm.
And I was able to run through that shit like I'd fucking played it yesterday. I remembered absolutely everything, all the secrets, everything. And it's one of those kind of things. And it's like even jumping back on, like I remember playing San Andreas somewhere between when GTA 4 and 5 came out, like in between those
like
two.
2013, 2014, so that came out.
Yeah. And I remember playing San Andreas again around that time, and I just fucking jumped back in. I remembered almost all of the missions and how to beat them. I remembered how to get myself around the map without setting waypoints. I just fucking went there. Like it surprises me how well I remember game worlds. As well as like my mum and dad do it quite a lot as well. Is often they'll actually phone or text me at really random times, and they'll be like, "We're watching this," and like. And then they'll send a picture and it's like, this guy was in something else, what was he in? And I'll immediately be able to tell him who the other character was that he played and what like TV show it was from.
Fair enough.
Like, it's even stuff like, I think Prison Break's been getting talked about again recently. And somebody asked me something about Prison Break and I was able to like fucking tell them, I think it was one, like, they said, what season does this happen in? And I was like, oh, it's like season 3, and I think the bit that you're referencing is like episode 5. And we actually looked it up, and it was episode 4 that it happened. And it was really, it was like, to be that fucking close for a series that I haven't watched in so long.
Fucking Prison Break's not one of the shows went on for far longer than it should have.
I still haven't watched it. It's like, for me, it's like Game of Thrones at this point. Like, it's gone on that long, and I haven't seen it.
You're just not going to bother at this
point. Just on principle, I'm not going to bother.
I think watch the first... Watch the... What?
Game of Thrones has titties.
It does.
I've watched the first episode of Game of Thrones.
For the titties, or...?
Well, no, but it's because Shawnee was like...
There was titties.
There's titties in this, and I'm like... I mean, okay, I suppose, but then, like... Because the intro was so long...
Yeah.
I watched the first one...
I do get bored
and then,
the intro.
I started watching the second one. I got halfway through the intro and not, you know what? Fuck this. I'm not even going to skip it because I know it's there and it's going to annoy me. I know that I've skipped 2.5 minutes of this like hour thing and that makes a difference to me.
Yeah. So yeah, I think that's probably my thing. It's not necessarily rooted in knowledge. It's just more in memory of game worlds.
I mean, the shit I know about a lot of that is like it's not really all that useful.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of bugs.
I feel like everybody's got a small stash of completely useless information.
Fucking mine ain't small, mate.
I mean, I know like the most useless thing that I know is that like if you take a knife and apply downwards pressure, you can't cut something. It's only when there's a movement that
it's gotta be a movement.
Like I don't know when that's ever really going to be relevant, but I know it.
If you're trying to cut potatoes quietly, that's relevant.
True. Yeah.
You're trying to, you know, kill people, it's relevant.
Yeah. You're trying not to fuck up killing people, very relevant.
Oh, yeah, I suppose, yeah. I never thought about it that way. Maybe it's not so useless then.
I think like every piece of useless information has its uses to somebody.
Yeah, but when is knowing how spiders move like that? The actual biomechanical function of a spider's movement, when's that ever going to be useful to me?
I thought that was interesting, though. I never knew
it's
that.
One day,
Alex, I'll tell you when it's interesting. One day, Alex, you're going to be captured. You're going to be captured, and you're going to be forced into like some kind of murderous sort of game show. Like imagine Saw, but a game show. And you need
I relish the opportunity.
And you need to answer questions to stay alive, and I'd fucking bet the final question is about that. And you'll know it. And you'll live. And then you'll be sad because it's over.
Apparently, fried tarantula tastes good.
Yeah, it's not felt.
There is nothing about that I want to go near.
Like, there's a thing on Snapchat just now about strange foods. And some of the shit they've been eating is weird.
But if you think about it, I mean, like, we're a fair country where, you know, boiled entrails in a sheep's stomach is a national dish.
Yeah.
So, like, I get it's all fucking frame of reference, yeah?
Yeah, what's weird to... What the fuck was that?
That was my me's... sniffing.
My me's.
My me's sniffing.
Oh, I thought it was because I shot a parrot in Battlefield. How did you know?
Wait, what, a parrot?
Yeah, I shot a parrot.
Nice.
There's a restaurant in New York that sells Bildick.
Nice.
Doesn't surprise me, funnily enough.
The restaurant in New York where you can get fucking like gold flakes in your fucking burger as well.
It's actually it's one of the arguments I use sometimes at work. Is that it's like what? Sometimes they
you lose I have a Bildick?
No, the so a lot of the like the
oh big... here's dump. I win.
A lot of the
look at him fucking Austin Powers.
A lot of the debates I have with the youngsters that come into my work often end up coming down to majority rule, and that's then what they believe to be the case.
Mm-hmm.
But then I almost always throw in the argument, so if majority rule, then eating dog is perfectly normal because we're in a minority for that.
Yeah, I mean it is in China.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, there's more like people.
There are a breed of dog that is bred to be eaten.
Yeah, there's more countries. There's more like cultures that eat dog than don't. So if majority rules, we're in the minority for this. How do you feel about that? And that's always what gets them thinking about stuff properly.
Yeah, I mean, like that being said about young people though, like there was a time not too long ago when I was removing like paint and stuff from ceramics and walls,
mm-hmm.
And to take it off the ceramic, we're using white spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So it's great stuff. But this particular young person had read somewhere that you can wash your hands with white spirit.
Idiot.
So he did it. So he tried it. And I was like, you do realize that your hands are going to start burning for the next week. He's like, no, it's okay. I can wash my hands. But no, you've just burned your skin.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I tell you about the time I fucking melted my shoe using white spirit.
Yeah, you did.
I was fucking doing a staging job and student. So, yeah, somebody had thought it'd be a great idea to just pour white spirit into a sort of half bucket. In fact, you know those painting trays, like roller trays?
Yeah.
Somebody poured fucking white spirit into one of them, and I was kind of, you know, walking across the stage, not really paying attention, stepped in it, melted the fucking sole off my shoe.
I mean, first question, why?
Why not?
Because some people who work in staging are only there because they can barely hold a fork.
So the ones that look pretty but can't actually do it.
This cunt did not even look pretty. Think fucking... Think Chunk for the Goonies. But... but with a mullet.
Half as intelligent.
No, it was a bit as intelligent. But the cunt had a fucking mullet and that's why you don't need to know.
Wow. That's bad.
Like, the sort of person that couldn't even roadie for the Three Blind Mice sort of thing, you know? Fucking, I've worked with some fucking morons in my time, man.
Has anyone ever heard of the comedians Andrew O'Neill?
The name
rings a bell. The ginger cunt?
No. He's kind of like, he's a gothic sort of guy. He's got long black hair, almost always dresses like a woman.
What's his name again?
Andrew O'Neill. I met him at Download. Because on the first night second night we decided to go to see the comedy gigs that they were running as the
recommend.
Sort of, huh?
Oh right, yeah, that guy.
Yeah.
And he was performing and Nat was telling me all about him and was really, really selling him and I was like, ah sure, yeah, I'll go along and I adored his set. It was so fucking funny. Like, he's a really, really funny guy. And it wasn't him, but it was another comedian of the night fucking nailed, like, exactly what it was to be at Download. And he was saying all these different things, and he was kind of taking the piss out of a few different people. He was taking the piss out of the audience and the kind of people that were there, as you do. And then somebody, like, for one joke, the audience kind of went, ooh. Like, it was one of those jokes that like was on the verge of funny but was really like cut deep as well. And he just said, what, let's be honest, we're all here because we got fucking bullied in school. And I've never heard a more true statement in my life.
Yeah,
well,
like,
yeah.
He fucking nailed that. Like, it was the best fucking thing ever that I've heard.
It's pretty accurate, man.
But yeah, it's fucking, I feel like I've been doing so much, but I feel like I have so little to speak about. But that's okay, because it's about time to wrap up.
Yeah. That's almost an hour.
Yeah. It's just...
Ross is a little happy with that.
Yeah.
So I can go play with the dinosaurs in peace.
Nah, he's playing Battlefield.
He's going to shoot these fucking parrots.
Bang, bang. Squawk, squawk.
Caca.
Fucking, that magpie really pissed me off.
That might be the highlight of this podcast for me.
Yeah, mate.
Look at the fucking shirt at that magpie. God damn it.
Does that mean I owe you 20p, by the way, Alex?
Yes, it does. A shirt at a magpie and my neighbours heard me.
So if you
you're going to get some funny looks tomorrow.
If you give me 90 pence, we're even.
Magic. I'm giving you 20, I can't make change. What have I got on me just now?
You're never...
I've got 5p on me.
Right, we're almost there.
And then I got about 10 in my bank as well.
Yeah, I've not got a lot of money in my bank. This was an expensive as shit month.
Well, you bought a car, went to London and to a festival.
Yeah.
And to Abilene.
Yeah.
I did not get hit by a car in Abilene. That was funny.
You what?
I did not get hit by a car when we were up. Well, I didn't nearly get hit by a car. I had fucking plenty of time, but the cunt thought it was about to hit me.
Oh, yeah, that was the guy that you ran out in front of with plenty of space.
Plenty of space.
The guy then beeped, slowed down, and then gave you the middle finger.
He gave me the finger. Like, reached across his child, basically pushing his child out the way to give me the fucking finger. Like, I don't know how it works in Aberdeen. But if you're in Glasgow and you've got a good fucking 50 feet between you and the car, you've got enough time to fucking make it. Yeah? Like
the green man is an advisory, it's not a rule.
Yeah, like, just taking it out of equation that pedestrians have right of way. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, he stopped, held up traffic to give me the finger. I didn't steal his sheep. This is the sort of guy who didn't look like he could get the ugly, like, now, you've seen Black Sheep?
Yes.
Mind the fucking weird sheep in that.
The one that looked fucking terrifying.
It's sort of man sheep type thing.
Yeah.
I doubt he could fuck one of them. The guy.
That's an image. Oh god.
Yeah. Fucking Abelino's fantastic noodles. Fantastic noodles.
Oh yeah.
Place was great.
But it doesn't have noodles.
It doesn't. No one's got noodles yet. We're still working on that.
We're still working on it. Yeah.
That is the best fucking business idea ever.
Yeah. That's what I was telling my brother-in-law about it this morning as well. He's fucking all about it.
I will leave my fucking job. We will end Badgering Pals and just run that as a business between all of us. Like that's a winner.
Yeah, it is.
Like through and through. Tried and tested.
Not,
there's no way.
I'm not gonna give it away on here because someone fucking steals it.
Absolutely. Yeah. No, we're never gonna say what it is. Never ever. But it's good.
No.
Right, shall we finish up?
Yes.
We should, yes.
Okay, may as well.
Ross.
Yes, darling.
Before we end on the podcast, can I ask?
Can you ask?
Since you're off.
Since I'm off.
And I'm very busy and we're short on time, can you edit this podcast?
You send me the file, I'll do it.
Thank you very much. Teamwork.
There you go, teamwork.
Teamwork.
That's fucking teamwork.
Yeah.
Fucking great song.
Yeah, it really is. Okay, so if you've enjoyed this podcast, you can head to badgeringpals.com. You can then get links to YouTube, Twitch, fucking store, Twitter, Facebook, and everything.
All that sort of shit.
Yeah.
All the shit.
All the things we do.
Just go to the website. Just do it.
Yeah.
Do it now.
Unless you're already on YouTube watching or listening to this, in which case, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more content every week.
Well done, whatever says.
Nah, do it.
And if you're on mobile,
please do it.
If you're on mobile,
do the same.
Do the exact same, apart from the website's a bit broken as shit. So I really apologize.
This section gets longer every fucking week.
we're gonna aim to get an hour long outro eventually.
Oh, that
fucking don't try us. We'll fucking do it. You know it.
We will do it.
That would be hilarious.
Yeah. So anyway, for anyone watching, please like our stuff. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye.